first appeared as a black spot against the blue, cloudless sky.
The children stood transfixed, hardly able to believe their eyes as the object drew closer.
A gigantic white balloon with a dome-shaped basket sped towards the clifftop with great precision, powerful, compelling, mysterious.
Closer and closer it came, until at last it hovered above the astonished children.
And then, from within the huge white sphere, an unearthly voice echoed. Strange voice told them that they must prepare themselves for a long journey to a place unknown to the men and creatures of Earth. At that moment, the balloon began to change, deflating quickly. In its place, a gleaming, long-nosed spaceship pointed skywards. Suddenly, it blasted off into the blackness beyond the Earth.
Sirius, the brightest star, hung above them, shedding the most brilliant light on the spaceship.
Then, the voice echoed through the silence. Sirius told them that without the Moonraker, there would be no more moonlight on Earth. Sirius told them that he would help them with their rescue by giving them some magic moon dust, which, when sprinkled liberally over the salamander, would make him grow big enough to carry them through the fire.
But the magic would not last long, and the children were warned that they must work quickly.
Finally, Sirius told them that he would guide them across the mountains of Mishkalmakor, but then he must leave them to complete the short journey.
So, with growing trepidation, the children
and the salamander
set off for the palace of Thor. As the spaceship landed, the sight of the terrifying wall of fire surrounding Thor's castle daunted the children. But there was no turning back. They set the salamander on the ground and sprinkled the magic moon dust over his body from head to tail.
It fizzed.
It faded.
Transforming the lizard into a gigantic beast of prehistoric proportions.
He obligingly crouched low enough for the children to clamber into his mouth and position themselves to peer out in the gaps between his teeth.
"I'm afraid. I want to go home,"
said one of them.
"I'm afraid too,"
replied the other. The great salamander started to move. His huge body lunged from side to side as he strode towards the fire. The children started to sing. Determined to stop their escape, so he unleashed the mightiest of storms. they had reached the safety of the moon.
The children had already decided to leave the Salamander with the Moonraker as her protector. She thanked them and promised to repay their courage by helping the moon to shine brightly forevermore.
They said their goodbyes and, feeling happy and proud, climbed aboard the spaceship for the last time.
Glad to be going home.